think there are two distinctive things that I took away from my London Business School education. The first is my friends and my network. I think the LBS community is an outstanding community. It's one that helps each other out. It's a small school, which I think helps quite a bit. And those connections have followed me throughout my career. And the second thing is I was not a financially rigorous person prior to coming to business school. And LBS gave me a pretty strong financial footing, which is obviously important if you're in the investment management game, which is what I am. When we're investing, we look at two things, and I think both of them have to come to the surface pretty early. The first is the size of the market or the nature of the market. So because we're looking for these new industry categories, we're looking for evidence that something has changed in the industry to allow a new kind of company to get formed, and really not even a new company, but a new kind of industry to get formed. And so we spend a lot of our time thinking about this. The second thing that we look for is not just the entrepreneur's background, but at who they hire. So we found consistently that great entrepreneurs tend to make they tend to hire even better than themselves. So their first employee, their second employee, all the way up to the fifth, tenth employee are folks that you kind of are left scratching your heads. How'd they end up getting that person to quit their fancy job at so-and-so and come join them? And we don't know if it's because of charisma, we don't know if it's because of the strength of the idea, we don't know if it's because of passion, but these three things kind of form and gel, and the good entrepreneurs are able to get great people to come and join them. The greatest opportunity is, I think, building on top of the existing platforms and going global as fast as possible. I think this is something that wasn't possible even 5 or 10 years ago and is very possible today, and you're seeing hyper growth for some of these companies. I think the challenge for companies, specifically in Europe, is raising the kinds of capital that they need to make these kinds of large, bold bets. I think it's very easy to do this in California, where there's an investment culture that backs young entrepreneurs or young companies and turns them into really big companies. I think that's lagging in Europe. The good news is I think you can build a business from anywhere in the world. I think Angry Birds is a good example of this. And you can go global everywhere in the world. They have 1 billion players playing the Angry Birds franchise games. And they did this in less than 5 years. So it's the scale, I think, is very, very dramatic today.